The Colorado is kicking off first, and we're ready to get this game underway. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And they can forget about returning this one. UCLA's coaching staff, they know they've got a star wide receiver. They know it's going to be a hostile environment. With that, we went to practice this week, Kirk. They had a crowd noise pumped up pretty good getting them ready for this game.
Yeah, they've done everything that they can do to get this offense ready for a tough environment. They had the crowd noise all week long, making it tough to communicate for the quarterback and his receivers. Now it's here. Now it's the game. And we'll see if all that preparation pays off. One thing we know for sure, they want to get the football into the hands of this receiver early and often if they want to win this game.
He's looking for his man.
Boy, Brad, this guy drops an interception. And what's ironic about that from going to the meetings the other day is that this guy's been telling the coaches he wants to play some wide receiver. You wonder why you're not playing wide receiver? Because you can't catch the ball as a defensive back.
He's taken down at the 45-yard line.
When they broke the huddle, I'm sure everybody knew the ball was going to go to this receiver. And he still brought it in to give this team a big lift.
Up the middle for a nice game.
That's a D7 on the play. That makes it second and two.
And they make the stop at the 37.
There's very good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they look sharp before this one even started.
And he's tackled around the 40-yard line.
Good discipline here by the defense, stringing the option out and plugging the running lanes. That moved them back.
From the 40-yard line, it's second down. Nice run up the middle. He gets sacked on the play.
But the defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only do they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that this defense is putting on him.
They'll line it up for a very long field goal attempt. UCLA could take the lead with this field goal. It has the distance, and he splits the uprights. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Excellent kick. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. He fights forward to about the 26. He gets a yard on the run.
This junior corner's been progressively improving his run defense. He's better at diagnosing those plays now. He knows how to bring a guy down.
From their own 26-yard line, second down. Throws quickly, and it's almost intercepted.
The defensive coordinator did a great job with the play call there. He put his defense in alignment in a position to be able to make a play on the football. Everything worked perfectly. They just dropped the football. Boy, the offense caught a break there.
Catches it, and he's looking for more. He's out of bounds at the 34. He punts it away, and it's a great kick. He's out to the 30, tries to get around the corner. That was a great hit. He wasn't getting away from that one. We're set to get restarted as the offense looks to build on the success of their field goal on the last drive. UCLA is up by three. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 37-yard line. defensive end came through to put him away.
Nice job of utilizing his athletic ability to get in there and then make a sure tackle.
Tackles him hard at the 39. Nothing doing for the offense, and it's fourth down.
That brings us fourth and seven.
Booming kick. Brought down at the 20. So he got a little on that return.
Well, Brad, early it looked like there was an opening there, but the seam closed quickly.
You never like to have the play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play.
Brought down right around the 30. From their own 30-yard line, it's first down. Short pass, middle of the field. He's tackled at the 37-yard line.
Pretty nice pickup here. These guys are getting very tight on their timing.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Right around the 46-yard line.
Number 10 makes the tackle at the 46-yard line. Another chance for another touchdown. First down.
Check in. Mike 35.
And down he goes at the 45. The offensive line got a really good push there, allowing the back to pick up 9 on the play. It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Tackle made at the 44-yard line.
Great job here converting and keeping this defense on the field. They're getting very tired.
Throws complete, and he's got space to work. And they finally push him out at the 19. From the 19-yard line, first down. And he makes it out to about the 17-yard line. This is the 8th play of this drive. And he's taken down around the 8-yard line. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. For the sack. Credit those two defenses in that first quarter, or blame the offenses for a lack of production. The Bruins with a 3-point lead. Welcome back. Tight game here in the second quarter as we begin play.
Three down.
Nice run there as they work the outside. So here it is, crucial third down as they try to take the lead. Got his tight end, touchdown. Converts the extra point.
So an 11-play, 82-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
An amazing drive for this offense. Outstanding execution. If you're the defense, you've got to do something to try to change things up to get this quarterback out of sync.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Fires out to his receiver.
That's good for a gain of 10 yards. That'll make it second and inches.
He's into the open field. He makes his way to about the 45.
Gain of 10 on the play. First down.
43's the mic. Check. Lion, lion.
And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That brings him second and 5.
Check. Blue 19. Blue 19.
He's hit and taken down.
That makes it first and 10.
Check. Blue 14.
They'll bring him down at the 22-yard line.
That's another first down, Brad. And right now, you can just really feel and sense the rhythm that this offense is in. Their ability to pick up first downs, just pushing this defense further and further down, back deep into their own territory.
Gains his way to the 10-yard line. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. He tackles him for a loss. Loss of 2 by the halfback. Here's the 8th play of the series. Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
Gain of 5 yards. That makes it 3rd and goal.
Now he tries to buy some time. Room around the corner. Decides to take it himself, and he's got it. Touchdown. And really a nice run there by that quarterback.
Well, great decision by the quarterback reading the defense, and as soon as he saw the open field, he cut it upfield and scored the touchdown.
Trying to go up by 3, they'll kick the extra point. And he adds the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Both teams are kind of struggling to take control of this game. Obviously, they're both very, very competitive with one another. It just seems that the lead is going back and forth between the two teams.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. On play action, defense coming. And he's immediately tackled. Short yardage situation here. Second down and 1. Pitches back. He gets it out to about the 47-yard line.
Two times.
Three down. Mike 35.
794.
There you go.
794.
There you go.
He goes out of bounds around the 46-yard line. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Fires quickly to the tight end. And they finally knock him out at the 13-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
big pickup through the air has made it first and 10. To about the 5. A gain of 8 on the carry. Colorado is going to use their first time out of the half here. He's on the run. And he's going to run this one in. Touchdown.
You know, he was looking and looking, and he finally said to himself, you know what, I'll just take this thing myself. Nice decision-making.
And he hits the PAT. A 6-play, 74-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. But the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
UCLA's offense is so predicated on what this wide receiver does. And now when you consider that we've got a couple of quarters left, they've got to change the complexion of the game a little bit. They're going to have to do it with somebody else, I think.
This is really where a coaching staff gets challenged, because for 5 or 6 days, you prep. And you look at a lot of film, and you kind of come into a game by the time Saturday rolls around, and you have a good idea of how you want to attack the defense. And then you go out there, and it's not working. You have to show an ability as a coaching staff to go back and look at that drawing board and eliminate some things and maybe add some things and be able to try to make the adjustments you need to give your team a chance to win in the second half.
And he throws it away. So it's 2nd and 10. Ball on their own 37. Quick to an open man, he dropped it. They keep it on the ground with the tailback. So they end up with a loss after calling the draw.
He started out rushing the passer and then just got lucky and ran right into the running back on the draw.
They get this one off, and it's a beauty. Tackle made at the 32-yard line. The offense ready for the first play of this drive. They move the ball extremely well on their last possession on their way to the end zone.
You can bet this defense made some adjustments on the sideline, though. I don't know if they can stop the passing attack, but they need to at least be able to slow it down.
Incomplete. Almost picked off. Nice job getting a hand on that one.
Yeah, really good heads-up play there to get a hand on the football by the defense.
From their own 32-yard line, it's 2nd down. Throwing right, and it's intercepted.
Well, he was facing a big pass rush. The ball had no chance of being caught by one of his teammates. That's what pressure will do for any defense.
Pushed out of bounds at the 39-yard line.
Gain of 15 yards. First down.
First and 10. Ball on the 39-yard line. Here's the throw, and I don't think he got anything on that. UCLA's going to take their first time out of the half. He steps out right around the 42-yard line. Third down now, and they need to get it to the 29. A screen pass, gets it to the back. He's taken down around the 32-yard line. Might have been some early movement up front.
False start. Offense.
That penalty will move them back a bit.
Yeah, and with so many young guys out there, it's bound to happen occasionally.
They call on the kicker for a long field goal. It's up. Looks long enough. Off the upright and in. Like they're ready for the kick. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Quarterback couldn't maintain possession on their last drive. Let's see what he does here.
Anytime you give the ball away, it's a disappointment. So these guys want to show that they can hang on to it.
And they make the stop around the 36-yard line. Colorado with a one-point lead. Caught, open field. And he's tackled at midfield. Right away. This quarterback doesn't seem to be having any trouble with the zone, does he?
He recognized the receiver was behind the coverage and he found him with a perfect strike. That's nice passing for a first down.
The kick is up and the field goal is good. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. So we've played two quarters. The Buffaloes lead 17-13.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. This game's been everything we anticipated it being. Each team matching each other blow for blow. Just a one-possession game at this point. What do you expect to change things in the second half?
Well, it's always fun to watch two teams and two gangs match up the hype. And we talk about it all week and how big this game is. And it's going to come down to players making plays. And, you know, the big play is something that we continue to beat into the ground. And which one doesn't give that up? A lot of times, you know, games are lost and won by turnovers and giving it away and making that crucial mistake. You can do everything right and you can execute right, but it just takes that one misstep, that one turnover to really put you in a bad position or a bad situation that can determine this game. That's what it looks like it's going to. Both teams executing well. Who's going to make a big mistake?
Just about ready to start the second half. We're going to watch all the games around the country, including some coaches who like to sample the surface that they're playing on. I'll keep an eye on that.
Yeah, I'm going to go to the cafeteria. You want some turf, some AstroTurf or anything?
Yeah, if they've got some, I'll chew on that in the second half. Here's the second half for you to chew on with Brad and Kirk.
Welcome back to the action. Second half just about set to begin. We got a tight game here. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. So we're just about ready to return to action. Colorado holds a four-point lead.
Handoff inside. He fights forward to about the 26.
That's a gain of one on the play. That brings up second and nine.
From their own 26-yard line. Second down. Zips it to the tight end. That's a great tackle at the 36-yard line. To get the first here on second down. And he throws it away. Throws it into coverage and it's intercepted. Down he goes, right around the 46-yard line. Spectacular play there by the linebacker to come away with that interception.
I don't even think the quarterback saw him on that play. He was right there waiting for the ball.
From the 46-yard line, it's first down. At the 41. Quick throw out to the receiver.
This is smart, efficient play call. You don't need to make the highlight reel on each play. Well, the question now is, how will they respond after losing a couple on that run?
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 36. It and hit immediately for a loss. Drop back 4 yards on that one.
That play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
Certainly they don't have the return on here. Oh, excellent punt. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. I'm sure the quarterback would love to make amends for that last pick.
So much in football is about how you respond to adversity. Moving forward after a turnover is a perfect example of that.
And he is drilled at the 28-yard line. Nice job by the running back, and that'll get him 7, maybe 8 yards.
That makes it second and two.
Second down and about 2 yards to go. Colorado is up four. Swatted away. He threw that to a guy who was well covered and it almost got intercepted.
Yeah, he's very lucky. That ball was only tipped.
Scrambling around. Brought down at the 43. We've got a first and 10. Ball on their own 43. At the 42-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
He delivers. makes the catch and gets out of bounds. It's first and 10. Ball on the 26. Down, and he's out of bounds. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 12. Colorado is up by 4. And he's taken down right around the 10-yard line.
That's a gain of 2 on the play.
That brings up this is the 8th play of this drive. Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown.
Give each of these guys credit for getting in sync, really fighting to create that touchdown.
And he converts the extra point. It was an 8-play, 79-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown. So the score now, 24-13. They line up to kick this one away. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. He's to the 40. He gets out to about the 44-yard line.
Did you see how much space there was for that tailback up front? He better be thanking his offensive lineman for that.
Set. Alert, alert. Blue 19. Bruin, Bruin. Blue.
They'll bring him down at the 44.
That makes it first and 10.
Some open field. He's at the 30. Tackle made at the 22.
You know that saying, get your keys out, because we're on a drive? This offense right now is on a drive. I mean, this is their third first down. They're doing just about anything they want, and they're really starting to wear the psyche of this defense down.
Makes it to the 22-yard line. Scrambling. He's taken down at the 18-yard line.
That's a gain of 4 on that. That'll bring up 36.
He throws left. Looks to a receiver. Touchdown. Designed play to the wide receiver, and it got him 6.
You said it, Brad, and a good time to call it. I tip my hat to the offensive coordinator.
And the secondary didn't quite seem alert enough to defend that pass. And he adds the extra point. A nice 6-play, 76-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
And the big plays that they have running the football were the keys to that drive.
The score now, 24-20. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Both these offenses stepping up and answering the bell. Who's going to blink first here?
Exactly right. I've just been impressed with the way they've been able to execute. I mean, there's a lot of pressure on them. Anytime you're feeling that the other offense can put points up on the board, there's a tendency to want to press. Neither one has done that up to this point, and right now it's going to come down to who can continue to execute, put points up.
This offense threw the ball extremely well on their last drive, and they ended up with a touchdown.
This offensive coordinator's got to be feeling so good about the execution that he's seeing from his quarterback and his wide receiver. Because, again, they put so much time into trying to put a plan together, and to be able to see that actually come into play makes you feel pretty good as a play caller.
Terrific coverage, and when you clog up passing lanes like that, you can force a quarterback to make some poor decisions. Almost got themselves a turnover, too.
Colorado holds a four-point lead. He goes out of bounds at the 31. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. Gets to about the 34-yard line. One quarter to go, and this looks like it could come down to the very end. 24-20, Colorado. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. It's away, and it's a booming punt. Oh, he got nailed on that one. Well, this is where stars are born. We're early in the fourth quarter. They're behind, but they got an opportunity to take the lead. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. Defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Third and long. This defense digs in here, and it could be their ball game. Got a man tackled for a loss. 7-yard loss on the play.
Well, that's just a sound play by the defense. They dropped him well short of the line of scrimmage.
At the 31-yard line. This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. Colorado is up four. Throws out and through his hands.
Number 22, the intended receiver on the play.
From their own 31-yard line, second down. Just gets rid of it.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Quick strike to the receiver. That gives him 100 yards in the game.
Even when he isn't open, the quarterback will still throw him the ball and just let him make a play. It really shows the trust that the quarterback has with his receiver.
He's hit and taken down. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 43-yard line. Complete, and he's out of bounds.
That makes it first and 10.
Double tight, guys, double tight. Two down, two down. Mike 35, Mike 35.
Go!
Throws this one away.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 29-yard line. They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. Boy, was he drilled as he let go of that football.
And he's going to feel that one tomorrow.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. Colorado is up by four. He unloads it. Caught end zone for the touchdown. So they're going to try to determine if the receiver had possession and was inbounds or not. They call it a catch, but the booth signaled down to the referee that they'd like to take another peek at this.
Man, as I see this play again, it really looks like he made the correct call on the field.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
So the call on the field stands. He makes the PAT. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. It's going to be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series. He's tackled right around the 32-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up second and three.
And he's going to be sacked.
But the defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only did they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that these defense is putting on him.
And they'll probably try to throw here. They line up on third down and 14. And they get the sack. And the defense gets to him again.
Well, this offense is running plays that are taking way too long to develop, giving the defense plenty of time to get after the quarterback. And boy, they're putting a lot of pressure on him.
Just under three to go in regulation. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. And down he goes at the 40-yard line. Not sure that touchdown in their last possession's given them some confidence, but let's see if that carries them back down the field.
And it was a really nice drive, too, Brad. The quarterback got into a nice rhythm and did a good job of picking apart the defense.
Gives it to the back, and they make the stop around the 40-yard line. UCLA's going to take their first time out of the half. From their own 40-yard line, it's second down. Nice run up the middle. UCLA will have one timeout remaining. And he stops. The defense punches them off the field after just three plays.
That was a short round, Brad. Nothing seems to be working right now.
Booming kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. We're taking a look at a seasoned defender logging another huge effort.
Now, this is the kind of guy that any defensive coach just loves. He's a tough guy. He's not afraid to mix it up, and he always seems to be around the football. And he's been able to get to the quarterback now a couple times as well.
Well, all of his good plays have added up to his team enjoying the lead. The defense shut him down on their last drive, forcing a quick punt.
Watch one, watch one.
All day. Down, Oklahoma. Cut.
Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. He's tackled at about the 31.
Hey, Bruins,
check
26.
First down.
Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter.
Lion.
He heaves it deep. Inside the 30. And down he goes at about the 23-yard line.
First down.
Polar bear! Polar bear!
Pulls it in, first down, and he's knocked out of bounds.
That makes it first and goal.
First and goal from the two. Let's see if they just don't try to power their way into the end zone here. And the goal line defense digging in here.
Blue 19. Hot.
Touchdown, Bruins. So the offense is going to go for two. Get 6 points on the board after failing the two-point conversion.
Well, Brad, right now this offense is hot, and they also took advantage of some mistakes there by the defense.
He got hit hard.
What a great effort here. Not just by the return team to cover the onside kick, but also by the kicking team to get themselves in that position in the first place.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Picked up a yard of anything on that run.
No gain on the play. That makes it second and ten.
What was that? Double tight, double.
From the 46-yard line. Second down. Under a minute left. And the halfback's got nowhere to go.
This guy is very physical, and he does a good job of taking on blockers.
Two tights, two tights. Two down, two down. 35's the mic. Good job. 648. And 48. Run, 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 run.
Here's an opening. Tackle at the 30. Big run on third down.
Anytime you can move the ball like this, you're putting a lot of pressure on that defense.
And the ball game's over, and our final score of this one, 31-26, Buffalo. That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.